It's called voiceless. Has technology rendered us voiceless? Has communication become a dying art form? Has electronics become the norm? I talked to my BFF yesterday by text. What the hell does sup, FML, GTG, K mean anyway? I hung out with some friends today online. We used to meet at a restaurant for lunch. Now we just post on Facebook what we had for dinner. Even the birds outside my window used to speak in song, welcoming the dawn. Now the birds outside my window have anger management issues. They're angry birds! And the only tweets I've heard lately are on Twitter. And what about couples on dates? They're not talking, they're texting. Could it be to other lovers or worse, to each other? Then there's internet bullying. Kids today might not necessarily feel fist on flesh. So why did the bruises take longer to heal? Parents add their toddler to their toddler to play. Hey, cheap babysitter, we used to spend time with our kids every day. Now we have a glorified pacifier on hand that's here to stay. Or play the iPhone game Baby Shaker, where the point is to shake your phone until you put the image of the crying baby to death. In the game, those babies are everywhere, on buses, on planes, in theaters, in grocery outlets. See how long you can endure the cries before you shake that phone until the baby dies. Newsflash. After numerous complaints, Apple has removed the iPhone game Baby Shaker from its online app store. Yes, complain, upset the Apple cart, shake Apple's empire to the core, bring them to the ground. Wouldn't that be delicious? And wouldn't your Granny Smith be proud? So what do you do when you're bored? Do you surf the web? There's something called technology addiction, and it's real. We are losing interpersonal skills. We are losing conversation skills. We are losing professional skills. Disconnect from tech and connect with the world. Go for a walk, play a board game, read a book, learn a new hobby, meet a friend for coffee, open the door for someone, smile, make eye contact, keep your phone in your pocket. Forget brick breaker, build concrete relationships, like conversation, then turn off your computer. Are the only ones still speaking CEOs in suits and ties, or politicians disguising their lies? No, listen, the poets are speaking, striving to keep the words alive. Yes, the poets will tear the words from the screen, from the page, engage in the roots of oral traditions that start in a variety of cultures like African, Aboriginal, Celtic, Caribbean. It is a revolution. It is the voice of our time, the spoken word. We will make sure the world will never be voiceless.